Today we have someone who's decided to be baptized. This incredible young man, his name is Kamani Grate, and she guys know about how I feel about Kamani right now. There's a scripture I want to read, it's Isaiah 55 in verse 10. It says, as the rain and the snow come down from heaven, and do not return to it without watering the earth and making it bud and flourish, so that it yields seed for the sower and bread for the eater. So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It would not return to me empty, but would accomplish what I desire and achieve the purpose for which I sent it.
Come on.
I really do believe that Kamani's heart is exactly what God's word sent out and to achieve.
Yeah.
He is the fruit that God's word yielded. And I'm so incredibly happy to be in your Bible studies, get to know you, get to randomly meet you on the street, and be able to be in your life and really see how much you've changed. See how much of a man of God you decided to be.
Yeah.
So I'm extremely grateful. I'm super happy. We're gonna be growing in Christ pretty soon. We're gonna be workers in the Lord, going out and trying to save the world in this generation.
Yeah.
This guy's the real deal, for sure. And so I'm gonna let my awesome brother Moses and then Abel come share a little bit about Kamani, amen.
Rico said it all. This dude is really he's the deal. He's very humbled and just someone really going hard for God. And there has been a lot of challenges. Like, dude, the cities that we have, like, we stay up so many nights. And this dude, like, he's like, bro, I just don't fall asleep. I'm not sleeping at all. And he's always energetic and just ready for the word. And it just so many minutes. I'm like, dude, I'm just so lucky. I don't know why God picked me to be in a study with you, but I'm very humbled to be here and doing a study with you. So, really, bro, you were amazing. You have got great potential, and I know God's going to use you mightily, and we're definitely going to evangelize the world.
Been awesome studying the Bible with you, man. I can tell after each study, man, you were enlightened. You were just lit up, dude. You kept saying, this is the missing piece, this is the missing piece.
Yes.
Especially after discipleship, this is a huge piece. But I'm showing you a scripture. It says, it's in Matthew 5-6. It says, blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled.
Amen.
And this one thing that stood out to me during the study, you said, it's a scary life knowing the truth and still living a life thinking that you're saved. And I just want to encourage you, man, stay hungry, stay thirsty, and I believe God will keep you, keep giving you the missing pieces to show you who you are in Christ. So, love you, man. Abel gave me, because like right now I have consistently been doing Bible studies with these guys behind me, and sleep, have not really cared about that, have not really cared about even eating, I haven't eaten today, and my stomach is empty and my spirit is full. Before I started the process, I fell off, and I was praying. I remember praying to God, like, please, like, I'm tired of sin. I'm sick of, like, going through the same thing over and over, and giving me this, falling to the same temptations, the same cycle. It was never ending, and I felt like there was nothing that I couldn't overcome it. I said that prayer, God, please, like, just save me. Like, I'm sick of it. This isn't what I want for my life.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember after that prayer, I'm on my way home from work, and I normally take the 108, which is on Slauson, and I took the 110 for some reason. It was God wanted me to take it.
Come on.
When I was walking home, in order to walk home, I had to walk past where they were tagging. Normally the 108, you don't, and it, like to get to my house, you don't pass the tagging area. So when I was walking home, Rico stopped me. He was like, "You want to do Bible study?" And right there, I knew like God, that was God saying like, "Here's your chance, like go for it." Like, of course, this is what God wanted for me. Like, this is, like I said, the missing piece. This is what I needed to be what I was really meant to be in this world. Just going through the studies and really understanding what it really means to be a true disciple. Thinking that before all this occurred and all this happened for my life and this healing and everything that has really, where I really was able to grow, I believed that I was saved. Like I thought, oh, like I'm fine, but I really wasn't. Man. And to really discover it has really just, it's powerful because Jesus like really does love each and every one of us to where like he would like die for us. Like that should be us on the cross. Yeah. Like we should be the ones that should be dead. We should be, just to even hear it in detail where he really sacrificed and went through everything. He could have called 10,000, any like a fleet of angels to just be like, "I'm sick of this, like I don't care, like it's over." But he stuck through it, and because of that, we're saved. And all we have to do is just surrender ourselves and really commit to living a life that in reality is the best life for us. With this life, he does exceedingly abundantly above all we ask or think. He knows our desires, and he shows out and multiplies that well above what we could even imagine. So I accept this commitment. And my momentum is like,
come on, bro.
Not even as soon, I already started because I tagged you guys yesterday. That does not stop working to build his kingdom. In the past, I've been very shy where I would like be to myself and like, I told them, like, I just use Bible plans at home, but now I'm, like, ready to, like, meet each and every one of you and do a Bible study, get to really know this Jesus that, get to know the person who really loved us, real love, not just love that the world teaches us, like, oh, this is what it is, unconditional, yes, something that will never go away. And just this morning, like, God has been preparing me, he's still preparing me for this baptism, I feel, because until that happens, like, he's been working on me. This morning, when I woke up, I remember, well, the night before, I'm kind of jumping around. The night before, one of my last studies was asking, they asked me, "Is there anything that you haven't repented of?" And I was like, I thought I already had to, like, repent of everything, like, put all my sins on the table. So I thought I was done repenting with everything, but this morning, I woke up, read my Bible, prayed a little bit, and right then and there, like, God spoke to me. He said, "Call your mother." For those that don't know, my parents were divorced, and she lives in Atlanta, so I haven't seen her for a few years, and, well, many years, half of my life. And hate and a lot of sins that have built on each other have built up within me that I didn't even realize. And just to get that thought, with no hesitation, I knew it was God, and when God speaks, I listen. So I heard that, I was like, call him, I was nervous, and I still did it. And just to hear your voice, I just couldn't even contain myself. Like, I just, like, it was, oh my gosh, like. But it was the best feeling to know that I was able to face my sin with God and really overcome it and repent. And I stand before you guys today, like, fully, I feel so free, like, it's so, I know what I'm talking about, but so amazing to feel the way I do. And I know that each and every one of us feels this way when we have Jesus. And we understand what it really means to be a disciple, and we actually go after it wholeheartedly with all our hearts, not just 70% and, oh, like, I don't feel like it today, like, I'm tired, and I, you know?
Call
so, I really, I thank each and every person behind me. I thank this church for welcoming me. I really admire, like, the fellowship. I've never experienced a church that had the type of fellowship that held. Of course, I've seen churches that have accountability partners, but you guys take it a step further and really get into each other's lives, and just to wit, I can feel it. Like, when I walked in, I just felt like instantly I was a part of the family. Yes. My family that has showed up, my dad. Girl in the north. Cool. My friend in the back, she works with me. And her boyfriend. And then over to the right, I have my friend Misha, her brother Brian. But not have a family here. But yeah, let's get to it.
All right, Kamani Grate. I have two most important questions for you. Do you believe that Jesus Christ came to earth, lived a sinless life, die on the cross for your sin, resurrect on the third day?
Yes.
What is your great confession?
Jesus is Lord.
Kamani the Great. Because of your great confession, we can now baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. You receive the gift of the Holy Spirit, and you be added to God's kingdom.
Father, thank you so much for this day. Thank you so much for coming on. Great. Thank you so much for this decision that's going to be for the rest of his life. God, we're so grateful for you washing the sins away right now, Father. Creating him in him a new creation, Father. So when he rises up out of this water, he's your disciple. Yes. He's your son, Father. Oh, yeah. We're so happy. God, just be with him, Father. Encourage him. And let us be brothers through you, Father. And I love you so much. Praise him. Just
amen.
Here we go.
We're
going to dunk you down, all right?
You guys ready?
Yeah.
You ready?
I get wet.
Whoa.
That's right.
Come on.
Come on. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb.